Welcome to Warp Perception, and I'm just gonna jump right into it and show you what we got. We have this L-head Briggs and Stratton engine with a transparent head that we built a few months back. Good job, Maddie. Wow, it looks great.
Yes.
How old are you, Maddie?
Two.
You're two?
Two.
2 years old, thank you.
Your turn.
My turn?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. For an ultra high speed shoot that we were doing for vision research. Now we were showing the combustion process from rich to lean in ultra high speed or ultra slow motion. And the other day, this video showed up in my subscription feed of these guys.
We're over our buddy John's here, and he's uncovering the Oakland.
That built something similar to the engine that I built that I just showed you.
Oh no, broke our flywheel. That's it for that.
And it reminded me of those clips. Now we're gonna burn a few different types of fuel. The first one is gonna be straight gasoline. The second is going to be rubbing alcohol, which a friend of mine, Chris, suggested. I really want to see the unburned exhaust gases exiting the exhaust port, so I'm going to go ahead and remove the muffler completely, get some earplugs, fire this thing back up. Ready to rock and roll. So that's what the alcohol looked like, and after looking at the slow motion footage, seems like the alcohol kind of rinsed out the cylinder and cleaned up some of the soot from the gasoline. And interestingly enough, it was really weird because it's like the cylinder was full of liquid, wasn't even vaporized, and the spark was still igniting it enough to push the piston down and run the engine. So it was kind of interesting. Now, for this one, I'm actually gonna put some safety goggles on because I've had some bad past experiences with acetylene. All right, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna start it up on the alcohol and then add the acetylene, which is gonna be this one right here. Here it goes. That was the coolest thing ever. So I'm going to do that one more time, but this time I'm going to turn the acetylene all the way up, full open, because there's so much soot coming out of there, but I think we're still going to be able to see it. So let's see that one more time and with the high-speed camera with the acetylene 100% wide open and almost no alcohol. So here it goes. Whoa! What happened there? Let's try that one more time. Okay, let's try. Okay, put that out. Put that fire out. Okay, here it goes. One more time. It looks like we overdid it on the acetylene a little bit, but props out to Kevin from the Backyard Scientist for suggesting the acetylene last, because now the head seems like it's completely unusable. I'm really curious to see if this engine will actually run on tequila. That's about it. Well, that was a lot of fun, and I hope you enjoyed that episode. And the most important to me is that you watch and enjoy our videos. I know that the equipment that we use is out of the reach of most of us, but the ideas are not. So if you have any ideas that you want to see come to life, just let us know. Let us know in the comments or send us a message. And as usual, tell us what you think in the comments below. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. And oh, and also, let me know if you want to see this engine run on tequila, and I'll try it out. I don't know if it's worth it because the alcohol was kind of, yeah, it was kind of looked like the inside of a washing machine. But I will try it if you guys want to see me try it. So let us know. Until next time, adios.